Hey everybody, it's Garrett with Tuning School, and in this week's Tech Tuesday, we're going to take a look at a couple different fuels and octanes and what works best for your setup. So you've decided now you might need to be able to switch some fuels around or even octanes on the vehicle that you're tuning. Let's take a look at a couple different fuels along with the octanes and find out what works best for your setups. First and foremost, we're taking a look and breakdown of four different fuels right here with four different octane ratings. Realistically, the easiest one for us would be our pump gas. Go fill up at the pump at maybe an 87 octane, 89, 91, or even up above there. That's gonna be the easiest for you guys to work with. You're gonna be able to drive up to the pump, fill up, drive off. In most of your guys' applications, that's gonna work great, and we're gonna break down a handful of those. Moving into maybe where we start to add a little more boost or even nitrous or something like that, we could add some different fuel additives into this. So if you're maybe a turbo guy or kind of that street strip kind of thing, that might be an option for you to choose. Moving further with that, we could have straight race gas right here. So if we needed to have race gas, maybe we have more than just a little bit of a mild build. We have a high boost application, or we're running a lot of nitrous, or even maybe just a ton of compression on our engine. And lastly, we have our ethanol fuels. So we're gonna have a very high octane fuel once again, but now we're gonna have to have larger injectors and a couple different things with that. So let's take a look at each one of them here. First one, pump gas. If you guys have a bolt-on or even a heads cam vehicle, most of your guys' pump gas would work great for you. If you guys are trying to get away with running 87 octane, you're probably gonna end up with quite a bit of knock, and that's not gonna work out too good for you. This is where you need to now move up into maybe that 91 or even a 93 octane from your pump. If you guys are filling up on this fuel, that's great. If you guys are using bolt-ons, heads cam, or even turbocharged stuff right here. If you're gonna use this, now make sure that you're staying on that low boost side of it though. You don't wanna go too terribly far with this. If for some reason you need to add some extra boost to this, or you're adding more compression or more nitrous, something like that, that's where we might need to move into adding a little bit of our boost stain into this. So that's where we add additives in here. If you're adding compression to your engine, you need to move that octane up. So something like this boost stain right here is gonna be able to now be able to raise your guys' octane up above that 91, 95, up into that 100 or even more range. So this is gonna help you get rid of that detonation on that engine. So now you can have that ignition timing into there and keep that temperature of that cylinder that much lower. Now, this isn't just your 100% fix for all race cars. This is an additive for your guys' street-driven vehicles. Yeah, sure, you can use it on a race car, that's not a problem. However, most of the applications that you guys for your street driving stuff, this is pretty much what you guys are gonna be able to run to on this. If you guys are medium boost, something like that, maybe in that 10, maybe 15 pounds of boost pressure, this would work great for you and get you guys going by, not a problem at all. Moving further than that, we would now have race gas, such as we see down here. If you guys have a vehicle that has very, very high compression, you're 12 and a half or even above compression on that, you have very high compression, you're gonna have knock and detonation. So you need to have a fuel that race gas such as 110 octane and above. So you're gonna have maybe something such as the VP fuel or maybe a Renegade fuel that we would be able to get with on this. So you're gonna have more even maybe some leaded fuels that you might end up running with some of this. Be careful with those catalytic converters on that because that can be harmful to this, okay? If you guys are running high boost applications, nitrous, or even just a straight race application, that race gas is gonna be for you. It's gonna keep that detonation away. It's gonna keep that engine happy and healthy for a long period of time. Yeah, it's a little expensive though, that's the catch. Now you're not working with pump gas prices of that $2, maybe $3 a gallon, and maybe even adding some boosting into this. You're dealing with $8 a gallon or even more. So if you have a race dedicated vehicle, that race gas is probably gonna be for you. But what if you wanted to save some money, and what if you wanted to still be able to fill up at the pump and run a ton of boost or even a lot of nitrous, yet save some money? That's where E85 comes in. You can fill up at E85 at the pump. So the catch with E85 is it's not always E85. It can blend a little bit. So that's where we're gonna have maybe a tool to be able to check out to make sure it is E85. Or if you guys had a flex fuel based vehicle. If you guys had a flex fuel based vehicle, you would not need to be able to measure for that ethanol at every fill up, okay? Now, if you guys have a heads cam vehicle, medium to high boost, or even if it's a low boost vehicle, E85 works great. The catch is with E85 is it's gonna burn roughly 30% more fuel. So you're gonna need a bigger fuel pump, you're gonna need bigger fuel injectors. So make sure that you guys are working with that. Now also keep in mind that this is going to be able to move around The octane on this can move up and down depending on what the seasons are. So if you're like me from Iowa, you know that it can sometimes in the winter get down to E60. It's not always E85, so that's why you need to either have flex fuel enabled on your vehicle, or you need to have one of those beakers in your hand and be checking that as those colder seasons hit. For more information about the flex fuel related stuff, take a look at this link right here. So now that you've decided what fuel you want to run, what about the stoic values or the lambda of each one of them? Let's start with the stoic side of it first. So taking a look at just your normal pump gas right there. Traditionally on our pump gas, we're going to see a lambda value of 1 and our stoic value of right around 14.7 to 1. So if we took a look at our stoic AFR 14.7 to 1, what happened if we added a little bit of ethanol to that, such as maybe E10, which is very, very common at your fueling stations. If you add E10 now to this situation, now your stoichiometric value goes down to somewhere in that maybe 14.2 range. What about even E15 now? A lot of people are seeing that at the pump even. So E15 now, maybe having a stoic value of getting even to that 13.8 range. So you can see that the stoic value even changes on that a little bit. But guess what? If we are always just using lambda, our lambda value of this would always be 1, okay? So now moving with our boostane, it's gonna be the same thing. We're still gonna be adding that directly to our pump fuels here. So lambda of 1, traditionally that 14.7 stoic value on this. Now if we go to our race gas, well, guess what? Same thing once again on this. The last part to this is gonna be our ethanol. Now keep in mind we had mentioned that we're roughly using 30% or more fuel to get the same burn. What we see here is a stoic value of about 9.8 to 1 AFR. But the beauty of this is if we're using lambda once again, lambda of 1. Now note on this, on each one of these, if we're using our lambda sensor properly, what we're going to see is if we have a lambda of 1, that's going to be stoic. If we go above that, that is going to be a lean condition. So it's going to run lean and by a percentage rating. So for instance, if I had a lambda reading of 1.09, that would indicate that I'm 9% lean. So that would be the same for each one of these fuels all the way across, hence why you should be using lambda. Now to go further with that, if I was to be able to go rich, if I have a lower number than 1 now, so now if I had maybe 0.85 lambda, that's gonna indicate that I'm 15% rich compared to a stoic value right there. So now it's gonna be an easy thing for you guys to be able to add or take away from your airflow and fueling tables inside of your vehicle. So now that you know the differences between these couple fuels and their octanes right there and how to use them with your lambda sensors, we can take a look at a couple instances of really what happens with the fuels. I've had in the dyno shop people come in with race gas in their vehicle right here. Not every car is gonna need that. A fair amount of times, even this week, I've had people come with race gas and we ran it through, drained the tank out, put a pump gas fuel in it, and made more power. Why is that? Because that pump gas is gonna burn hotter. And on top of that, it's cheaper. So if you can get away with that pump gas right there, certainly do. There is a time and a place for that. So that's where we're taking a look at the couple of different instances we've given you. You need to decide what is right for your platform. We get this question all the time, and I see it in the shop all the time. What should I use? Well, it just depends on what your setup is. There's no one correct answer for that. It depends on what you're using on your vehicles. I hope you enjoyed this video, and now you know what fuel works best for your setup. For more high performance tuning knowledge, follow us on social media, and as always, stay tuned.